What's good? Welcome back to Invest and Trade with Jax. We're going to go over our friend Solana. Currently, we're sitting at an even 200. We're up about 3.7 on the day. We're sitting at a market cap of 61.646 billion, 24-hour volume, 1.99 billion. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're new to crypto.com, sign up to the world's fastest growing crypto app, and you can grab one of the incredible Visa cards for cashback in crypto, free Spotify, Netflix, Prime travel incentives, $25 in crypto just for signing up through my referral. So let's look at Sol, guys. So we've come right up to our next take profit zone at 201. We do have bearish divergences on the 1 hour time frame. Price is rising while the indicators, the RSI and the money flow, are creating lower highs, which is a bearish divergence. Our entry was 178. So currently you're up on your trade. I'll throw my trade up on the screen. A juicy 11% for Solana. So we do have to keep an eye on a pattern that I've noticed here, which is a bit of a rising wedge for Sol. So just keep a close eye on this level of support at about 196. If it is broken, we can come back down to the bottom of the wedge, which is just under our first buy zone at 188 for Solana. So I'm just gonna quickly close the, actually let's pop over to the 4 hour, see how our indicators are looking. Okay, our indicators are looking okay on the 4 hour chart, but we are trending towards overbought. And that is usually where you see a little bit of a move back down. As you can see right here, we're overbought, move back down, overbought right here. Massive move back down. Sometimes you're gonna see those moves as well. That's why I'm always dollar cost averaging. I'm always ready for the drop. Equal amounts at each buy zone. If you're spot trading, bring your average price down halfway each time. If you're leverage trading, you have to double your margin, all right, guys? So we've broken out of our falling wedge. Looks like we're slowly making our way up to our target. We're back above the EMAs. We'll pop over to Solana on the daily. We're looking really healthy, guys. Everything that we've been predicting has come to fruition. I talked about the ABC correction, the throwback up into our pattern here, as well as trending towards oversold on the daily. And that's usually when we see a bounce, just as we did back here. We're oversold, massive bounce to the upside. So we're seeing a nice little push. We're back above the EMAs. We're back above the 55 as well, which is really, really bullish for Solana. If we can hold the EMAs, we have the bullish cross on the daily. It's a huge sign of a pump, guys. I'll show you the last time we had the bullish cross right here. Massive pump for Sol. We do have to keep an eye on a possibility of a head and shoulders pattern. Here's your left shoulder, here's your head. If we, excuse me, if we do roll, if we hit resistance, we start rolling, we could create that right shoulder. Sorry, guys. I was eating some almonds and they're getting a little bit caught up in my throat here. So we're back above the EMAs. We're getting back above the 0.786. Just keep an eye on that right shoulder. It's the same thing with Bitcoin, right? The possibility of that head and shoulders pattern. I'll show it to you guys in a sec here. But Bitcoin is still holding that level of support. We came down to oversold. We're seeing a little bit of a push here, but we'll open it up on the daily. So you can see here, here's your left shoulder, guys, right here. Here's your head. Here's the possibility of a right shoulder. So we have to keep a close eye on that. And you can see Solana is mimicking left shoulder, head, possible right shoulder. But as of right now, we're back above the EMAs. So if we come up and break 218 and break this high, we can invalidate it. Our bull run target for Solana is all the way up to at the 2.272, which is coming in about 503, based off our Elliott wave theory. We have our impulsive wave one from the beginning of our bull run. Let me zoom out here. Impulsive wave one, corrective wave two, largest wave three, impulsive wave four, corrective wave four, and our last impulsive wave five, all the way up to our bull run target of 500 for Sol. All right, guys, but in the short term, do keep an eye on those bearish divergences on the 1 hour time frame, as well as that rising wedge, possibility of a rising wedge pattern. You can see here, level of resistance, level of support. Let me drop this in a bit closer here. So we can invalidate it by breaking 201 and seeing continuation. But if we do roll over, we lose 196. You target the bottom of your wedge, coming in about 183. All right, guys, our first entry was 170. I have taken some profits up here, of course, and then I'll let the rest ride. We come down to 188. I'll re-enter. My average price will already be lower than the current price. And our dollar cost average buy zones, 188, 178, 170, 157, 141, 115. Take profits, 201, 216, 231, 257. It's just for reference, guys. It's not financial advice. You don't have to necessarily buy these exact zones or sell at these exact take profit zones. They're just for reference. If you want early access to these charts, guys, I'm posting them, updating them basically daily here in our DCA charts on our Discord. It's the price of a coffee, 350 USD. You really can't beat it, guys. And then we also have over 1,000 members talking all things crypto, posting chart patterns, incredible trading, investing community. And if you want to trade with me, sign up to Bybit, $4,100 in bonuses for a limited time. Check out crypto.com. You can follow me on IG, and I'll see you in the next video. Much love. Take care.